Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I am Dr. Afreen Farooq, MBBS, FOGS and FAM from Elamed, Alhamdulillah. I am a hijama specialist also. I am practicing hijama for PCOD cases, for menorrhagia, amenorrhea, infertility, mashallah, psoriasis, skin diseases, for allergies, alhamdulillah, for joint pains. As it's very good, subhanallah, it is sunnah. But today I just want to make it short, and I want to answer few questions from my colleagues who are practicing hijama in USA. One of my friend, she called me and she asked me about a doubt of blister during hijama. So what does it indicate while doing hijama? On the skin you find blisters. So subhanallah, it's very simple. It just shows that the disease is severe. And you don't have to worry about the blister. You just have to leave it like that if it's very tiny or something like that. Or if it's big with a sterile blade, you can just puncture it and release the fluid and tension from it. You don't have to worry about it. And second question is, mashallah, the hijama therapists who are non-professionals, yani they are not doctors, subhanallah, but they have been practicing hijama and they keep questioning, can we do hijama on breast? There is a patient, one female with lump in her breast or some cyst kind, fibroadenoma, shall I do hijama on breast? And I was really quite surprised by her question. Because how less of knowledge they have, though they are practicing it since so many years, subhanallah, so many books I have read about hijama, mashallah. Everywhere it's written, you're not supposed to do hijama on breast. It is contraindicated. So my humble request to the hijama therapists who have little knowledge, I always request them, even on Facebook, they keep questioning, what points should I cover for PCOD? And to be honest, I really get mad on such people. Like, you have such little knowledge about what you're practicing and you're playing with the lives of people, health. Yani their lives are at stake. They come with some trust in you, subhanallah. So you should at least acquire a bit of knowledge, you know. It's not advisable to do hijama on breast, and anyone who is getting hijama on breast, please stop it. And if you have been doing it, please stop it. It is contraindicated, subhanallah. And that's it. I will talk about fainting during hijama and what are the do's and don'ts during hijama in another clip. Maasalama.